Turn the spate of attacks on correctional facilities across the country in recent times, which has become a source of internal security threat to the country, also notes that in the last couple of years, over 20 cases of jailbreaks have been recorded across the nation, instigated by both internal and external forces. Correctional centers in Borno, Enugu, Oko, Kotonkafe, Oyo, Kano, Edo, Ondo, and Owerri, amongst others, have been attacked and a huge number of inmates released into the society. Aware that these recent jailbreaks, particularly the Owerri case, where over 1,844 inmates were released and operational tools completely destroyed, have heightened insecurity in the country, disturbed that the forewarning of the jailbreak was allegedly not acted upon by concerned security agencies to prevent the attack, despite proximity to the correctional center. Also afraid that this pattern of jailbreak, the audacity and the sophistication with which it was carried out, portends greater danger for the country. Also afraid that the armed squad of the Nigerian Correctional Service in its present form and character might not be properly and adequately equipped to deal with these challenges, hence the need to strengthen the security architecture of the service. Cognizant that occurrence of jailbreaks are mostly consequential effects of poor prison management and the situation that best describes the Nigerian correctional facilities, of course, an indication of a failed prison system. Also cognizant that the Correctional Act 2019, which repealed the Prison Act 2004, provided for the rehabilitation and reformation of inmates and eventual reintegration into the society, as well as for measures to eliminate overcrowded correctional facilities, which in itself instigates violence and enables jailbreak. Concerned about the general insecurity in the country and increasing concern from the safety of lives and properties aggravated by these jailbreaks across the country, worried that continuous violation of these correctional facilities, if not checked, could lead to further deterioration of the insecurity which was gradually improving in the country. The House resolves to urge the Comptroller General of Corrections to immediately reinforce the armed squad of the service as part of measures to prevent and forestall future reoccurrences. Effective collaboration between the federal and state government should be immediate to tackle threats to these facilities, particularly to beef up security around correctional centers nationwide, the Nigerian Correction Service and other security agencies to intensify efforts to recapture escapees in view of the danger it portends. Also mandate the House Committee on Reformatory Institution to investigate in a holistic manner these incessant jailbreaks and the general violation of correctional facilities across the country and report back to the House within the 60 days. Within 60 days, I so move. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Small allergy. Motion is urgent and important enough. Please say aye. Those against, please say nay. Ayes have it.
What I'm telling them is, please be strong, just like the Bible says. Be strong, be courageous, and believe in God. And let us protect ourselves. That is the truth. You have to protect yourself. That is why self-defense is enshrined in the law. Yes, if someone comes to attack you, and in the process of you protecting yourself, the law will look at the proportionate measure. If the proportion you used in protecting yourself is commensurate with the proportion in which the person used to attack you. So, to my people there, please, let us be vigilant, be prayerful, and please protect yourselves. These killings, it's far too much to bear. I don't even have any other words to describe it. It's very pathetic.